Hi friends, please subscribe to Amravati Media and press the bell icon for more latest updates.
Honorable Chief Minister, Jagan Mohan Reddy ji, my cabinet colleague Kishan Reddy ji, my colleague Honorable State Minister General V.K. Singh ji, Minister of Road and Building, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Sri M. Shankarna Narayana ji, all the Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Member of Parliament, MLAs, and all brothers and sisters. It is a pleasure for me. Today we are marching ahead for the development of new infrastructure in Andhra Pradesh, and that is really a great pleasure and pride for me. Before our government, up to 2014, the total NH in Andhra Pradesh was 4,193 kilometers. Now till May 2020, it comes to 6,860 kilometers. It is the length of national highway in Andhra Pradesh before. Whatever the increase in it is 2,667 kilometers. That is 64% in the 6 years. Regarding the expenditure also, the total sanction accorded since 2014 was 32,250 crores, and total expenditure coming up to 24,225 crores. The work costing rupees 8,869 crores are targeted for completion by 2021, and project to be awarded in 2021 is 11,712 crore rupees. Projects likely to be completed during current year, which are very much important. The total projects are 28 number. Length is 651 kilometers, and cost is 8,869 crores. Where I am confident that we are going to complete this project this year. These projects are very important. 6 lane of Rastasthalam Anantapuram section, construction of 4 lane ROV and its approaches in the Murkambattu of NH 18, 4 laning of NH 9, including 6 lane elevated flyover that is in new NH 65. I have got the list of all these projects, and that project cost includes is approximately, it comes to 9,000 crores. I am confident this project is going to change the scenario in the Andhra Pradesh. As far as the development in Andhra Pradesh is concerned, we are very much committed, because Andhra Pradesh is one of the progressive state, and there is a huge potential for industrial development. For this year, where we are going to awarded the projects, for this year our we are now in position to award this project. The cost involves 11,712 crores of 535 kilometers. Projects number is 13. These projects of 2 laning with paved shoulders of Lamsingi to Paderu section of NH 516E. That is of 48 kilometer, cost is 361 crore. Date of award is March 2021. 2 laning with paved shoulder of Shaprati Palem to Lamba Singhi section of 40 kilometer, cost is 311 crore. We will award it March 2021. Oyakuru to Chhatrapati Palem, 2 lane. March 2021, we will award this project of 350 crores. 2 laning with paved shoulder with Baudara Vijangaram section. That and then 3 lane elevated flyover from Jyoti Mahal Junction Ramesh Hospital Junction, two-laning with paved shoulder with Paderu to Gudiguda section, two-laning of paved shoulder of Gudiguru to Araku up to Ballaguda section, then six-laning of Renigunta, Naidipeta section. The cost of this project is 2,225 crore. Widening and strengthening to two-lane with paved shoulder of Salaru to Gajapatni Garam, construction of Kadri Bypass, then Bangalore Chennai Express Highway 85 km, part of it in Andhra Pradesh. The cost involved is 5,175 crore. Before March end, we will start this work. Four laning of Khammam Devarapalli section, 72 km, cost is 1,571 crore. Widening of two lane with paved shoulder from Pomaru to Akhivedu section, that cost include 530 crore. So these are 535 crore and cost includes is 11,720 crore. 100% we are going to award this project. Already the total project 45 numbers. Length is 2,209 kilometer and cost is 32,175 crores, where the DPR is already ordered for that and some of the DPR are finalized. Immediately we will try to start this project. That is Akhivedu Digarmaru section, 46 kilometer of 450 crore. Madnur Kadappa, that is 51 kilometer 180 crore. Orumilla CS Puramu, 56 kilometer, that is 525 crore. CS Puramu to Singarakoda, 90 kilometer of 872 crores. Bhadrachalam in TSAP, that is 38 kilometer, 204 crores. Border to Jelangulti, Jangareddy Garden, Devarapalli up to Rajamundri. It is finalized, NIP is finalized. Then Ramakodavaram to Koyaru. This is also the year, for this year we will award this project. Suryapet to Khammam, Ashwaraport, Konur section. Vijayawada, Jagdalpur, 64 kilometer of which we are going to award. Near Devratapalli Reserve Forest, 21 kilometer. Nagarjuna Sagar Dam to Devalapalli. Then Kaveli to Udayagiri, Setu Bharatpuram, Setu Tharampuram. This DPR is in up to NIP. Araku Bodara section, DPR is to be taken up. Improvement to hairpin beds on Hyderabad, Sheri Silam, Dornala, Kokapalli Road. DPR is in the final stage. Maidukular in Pormekula section. In Molakachuru to Madapulla section, construction of tunnel and realignment to avoid hairpin bends in ghat portion, then bypass road to Lipakshi, then Chintur to Motu section, Vestarvepeta to Ongole section, DPR is under preparation, Ballankiri Sambhavarampuram section, DPR is under preparation, Kadappa to Renigunta section, FAPR submitted to Bharatmala. Bangalore-Chennai Express Highway is very important. It is also very important for the state of Andhra Pradesh. The cost of the project is more than 5,000 crore. The part in Andhra Pradesh. Then Madapalle to Pilleru section. Then Pilleru to Chetropalli sections. Odisha to AP border, 100 kilometer. That is Sabavaram section. That is Raipur-Vishakhapatnam. Then Medukur Badavel section, then Karnataka AP border, Chintankunta Adoni, that is of 2000 crore project, then Khammam Devapirri section, that is Telangana AP order to Borampalam village, then Khammam Devarapalla section, Borampalam village to Devarapalli village, development of Greenfield bypass road for better connectivity to Gangavaram port in Vishakhapatnam district. Let four lane beach road connecting Gangavaram port to SEZ at Achutapuram in Visakhapatnam district, upgradation the existing four-lane road of connecting to Gujuwaka, Gangavaram port into six-lane road in Visakhapatnam district, Vakkalpudi junction of Annavaram junction meeting, final feasibility report is submitted, encourage old port area to Anchampetta junction, development of Greenfield Road connecting Machilipatnam, upgradation of Manglipudi Beach Road, 4-lane road to connect Machilipuram, development of 4-lane Greenfield Road from Machilipuram North Port to NH-46, development of 4-lane Greenfield Road from Machilipuram South Port to NH-9, construction of 4-laning of Chilakaru Crossroad to Chintavaram, construction of 4-laning of Chintavaram to Turukukanpur, 6-laning of Turukukanpur to Port South Gate with a spur to Vargili from Gunampadiya, Cheninga, Package 3, construction of 6-lane Greenfield Road connecting North and South Industrial Cluster of Kandarlelu Creek near Krishnapatnam Port at Varangali to Moluer near Muthukur and extension of dedicated port road. 6-lane Greenfield Road from Krishnapatnam Port from Naidipeta and Port Connectivity Road 4-lane from East Breakwater to Convert Junction. So these are the length of 2,209 kilometers and the cost is 32,175 crores. We will try, the DPRs are on the final stage. We will try to make it the start of this project for the next year. The port connectivity is very important and we have already taken 24 projects. The length is 404 crore and cost is 7,400 crore is involved. The connectivity of Kakinada port to Rajnangaram and Samalkota, 2 to 4 laning of road connectivity of Kakinada port from Samalkota to Rajnangaram in Godavari district, then Greenfield Road connecting North and South Industrial Cluster of Kandarlelu Creek near Krishnapatnam Port, 4-laning road of Nellore City. This is the list is with me. These are the big projects and where we are specially think on about the port connectivity. The most important thing is regarding port connectivity is going to helpful for Andhra Pradesh for new development, for new industry. And it is very important. Already we are giving highest priority for that. Majority of this road we are making DPR and we will 100% resolve the solve the problem and fulfill the expectation of the Chief Minister and the people of Andhra Pradesh. So now this 704 crore is very important. Regarding this express highway network is also equally important. The Bangalore-Chennai Express Highway, where a total length of 262.100 km, out of which 85 km length, Bettemangala to Gudipula section, falls in Andhra Pradesh, which is proposed for 4-lane. This is very important. I will request Honorable Chief Minister that under your chairmanship, please you call the meeting of all NHI work with your officers, Chief Secretary, and my officers from Delhi, and even NHI officers. And in this meeting, my request to you that with the agenda of your state, we can resolve the problem and we will expedite the work. The post bifurcation of the state of government of Andhra Pradesh plans to develop Rayalaseema region by providing better infrastructure facilities of the making it major potential up for industrial development. Therefore, an access control expressway has been planned for better connectivity of capital region, coastal and northern region of Andhra Pradesh, that is Amaravati Anantapuram Express Highway. The proposed expressway connect Amaravati, new capital city of Andhra Pradesh, with Anantapuram and Rayalaseema region. It takes off from the National Highway 44 near Marur in Anantapuram district and terminates at Chikalpuria bypass near Chikalpuria in Guntur district. The proposed express highway provides a major connectivity between NH 44 and NH 16, which are lifeline in the state of Andhra Pradesh. The expressway passes through four districts, Anantapuram, Karnool, Prakasam and Guntur in Andhra Pradesh. This is also important project. Once you come to Delhi, we will discuss in details about it. About the ring road of Vijayawada, Amravati. The proposed ring road runs around the proposed capital city of Amravati and passes through the district of Krishna and Guntur and does fast, better movement of traffic. This project decongests the traffic of NH-16 and 65 passing through Vijayawada city. The ring road shall decongest the roads in capital city. And as far as the land acquisition is concerned, my request is, once you come to Delhi, already it was promised by the previous government for giving me 50% cost for that. But still, we will discuss the issue. If some problems, we can resolve that. That royalty on aggregate, then GST on steel and cement, you can make exemption, that can be a notional loss. And we can reduce the cost. So by which your contribution for adding of 50% of land acquisition can be reduced. But once you come to Delhi, we will discuss and we will try to resolve this problem. The total CRF sanction, presently sanction according to in this year, is already 681 crore rupees works have already started, already sanctioned. And when you comes to Delhi, we with the presence of the concerning officers, we will sit together. And if there is any provision for me to give more sanction, I will definitely try to give it. Regarding today is one of the important flyover. I got opportunity to visit there. That Vijayawada Durga flyover is very good. It is a pride for the country. I remember when Honorable Vice President of India, Venkaiah Naidu, at that time he was the Urban Development Minister. In his presence, I visited the spot. I also go to that Mandir, Mata Mandir at that time, Durga Mata Mandir. And I understand the importance of this flyover. The Vijayawada MP is also making follow-up for this flyover many times to me. It is really a pleasure and pride for me that today we are completed this flyover. This is going to be one of the important flyover. The other projects are very important. About the accidents, I will request you, road accidents. Every year in the country, we have 5 lakhs accidents and 1,50,000 deaths. In Andhra Pradesh, already on National Highway, 435 black spots have been identified. Temporary rectification measure completed for 295 black spots. Permanent rectification measures completed for 150 black spots. And temporary rectification measures for balanced black spots targeted for completion in 2020. The permanent rectification measures for balanced black spots is targeted for completion by December 2021. My request to you that please give highest priority for how we can save the life of the people. We have to reduce the number of accidents. This is very important. The Tamil Nadu government successfully reduced the road accidents and death by 25%. My humble request to you and your colleagues, cabinet colleagues and the Home Ministry, that if you can plan and taking measures, there is a good example of Tamil Nadu. On the same time, World Bank, ADB is now helping to us. They are ready to sanction 14,000 crore for improvement in road engineering for black spots. I am ready to support you. My suggestion is on a mission move. If you can decide to accept this challenge and 100% resolve this issue, then that can be a great thing for the people of Andhra Pradesh. I am personally very much sensitive and I will support for this mission for you. Today's Lokarpan of 10 project, that is cost is 8,006 crore and 529 lakhs. They are very, very remarkable roads. And I am confident that by this road, 100% giving great relief to the people of Andhra Pradesh. Regarding the benefit of all these projects are very good. And I am really happy that people of Vijayawada, people of Andhra Pradesh, they are benefited from all these projects. This is really a great pleasure for me. And today's Bhumi Pujan of 51 projects, the length of 873 kilometers and cost involved is 7,366 kilometers. Under your able leadership, guidance and cooperation, I am really confident that we will achieve this goal and we will complete all this project before time. Today, regarding the Minister of MSME also, we are doing a lot of projects in Andhra Pradesh. Today, I will request you, regarding the development of Andhra Pradesh, creating more employment potential and the growth in the country, particularly from Khadi and village Gramodyog industry and MSME, I am really want to support you. You can make lot of ports develop and you can make their good industrial development area. It can create more employment potential for the youth of Andhra Pradesh. I am confident that for this reason, as a government of India, from my side, as a MSME ministry, Khadi village and ministry, I want to support you. I will definitely going to support you in this manner. And my request is to plan a vision for Andhra Pradesh, where I am 100% will help you for handloom, handicrafts, and other things. There are a lot of handloom and handicrafts area in Andhra Pradesh, which is very important. And 100% for the port connectivity, the 25 port connectivity projects, total length of 4,400 kilometers, where already we have finalized. Then four upgradation of two-lane and power shoulder of the stage from Kaveli, Udayagiri to Setupuranam, we will immediately start this. Then development of Narsapur bypass, with your request to me, the sanction of the civil work may be taken up in next year. Annual plan, at present DPR may be initiated. Bangalore-Amaravati expressway may be taken up under expressway. That decision we have to take, when we discuss, we will find out the way out on it. Widening the urban link of Anantapur town of the state of Andhra Pradesh. The project has been accommodated in the current 2021 annual plan for amount of rupees 90 crore. However, the actual cost of the project is 350 crore, for which additional section selling of rupees 250 may be agreed. We can agree for that. There is no problem. So, presently we are facing the problem because of COVID-19. But just I am confident that with positivity and self-confidence, we will 100% win this war against COVID-19. At the same time, we will economic war. So in the next month, I will be in Delhi to come with your officers. Regarding my ministry, we will fix up the meeting. We will resolve the issue. You are a member of parliament from Andhra Pradesh. Many times they are meeting me. I am always trying to help them. So we will find out the way out. And we will make a world standard infrastructure in Andhra Pradesh. This is my promise to you. Whatever I am going to declare, 100% we will complete that. Under the leadership of Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji, we are very much committed for development of Andhra Pradesh, and 100% we will do it. Once again, I am giving my all thanks to you and best wishes to you. Thank you very much. Namaskar.